सकता है सच कर। वेल आज डिस्कस टुडे इज द फर्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल विच वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ इज द प्रिज्माटिक कंपास एंड फॉर स्टडी ऑफ द प्रिज्माटिक कंपास एक्चुअली दिस विल नॉट बी अ प्लेन ग्राउंड वेर एन यू आर गोइंग टू डू द सर्वे इट विल बी वेरी अंडुलेटिंग ग्राउंड बट येस द सेशन पॉइंट्स आर विजिबल एंड नाउ द लोकेशन विच हैज बीन डिस्कस टू यू दैट यू आर एबल टू ड्रॉ द ट्रायंगल फॉर थ्री स्टेशंस लेट अस से इट इज ए बी सी विच आर गोइंग टू कवर द एरिया विच यू वॉन्ट टू सर्वे सो फॉर प्रिज्माटिक कंपास वॉट यू नीड इज द फॉलोइंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स लाइक द प्रिज्माटिक कंपास ट्राइपॉड स्टैंड ट्राइपॉड दैट इज थ्री लेग्स 30 मीटर्स टेप वन पेग एक्चुअली देर आर थ्री पेग्स रिक्वायर्ड एंड द रेंजिंग रॉड सो दीज आर द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स विच यू विल बी नीडिंग फॉर द प्रैक्टिकल Now, as sir has kept the tripod stand, is to be kept, rather it is called fixing of tripod stand with a prismatic compass on the station. So, all those procedures we will repeat one by one. Let us wait for. So, to start with, what we are assuming is, let us say this is the first station which sir is marking with the ranging rod, which is of 2 meters to 3 meters. See, it is colored. Bands are available with red and green or black and white. Red, white, black, white. So this is the another station sir have marked. This side. So this is just a demonstration that how stations are marked. Sir. So we are selecting these three stations. In such a way that the distance should be 15 to 20 meters. I will tell you the reason why we are doing that. See, when you are putting the ranging rods, they should be vertically inserted into the ground. So this is your first step, and you have to select these three stations in such a way that they will cover the whole area which you want to survey or which you want to cover. Let us say this is station A, and on station A, whatever the ranging rod is available, I will take it out, and exactly at the same position, I am driving the peg into the ground. Now, the first step is the temporary adjustments, fixing the compass on the given station points. So this will require little bit practice, and here I am checking whether the centering is done or not. See, it has been fault here. That means this leg is to be taken little bit in, okay? So radially inward and outward, the legs are to be moved so that you can check it. See, it has been fall here. That means this leg is to be taken little bit radially outward. And this is the third try I am trying with, wherein the peg is exactly falling on the, the stone piece is exactly falling on the peg. See once again. See, the peg has fallen exactly at the center. So this is centering. Once centering is over, you have to fix the compass. So fixing of compass, you have to rotate the compass in clockwise direction. So there is a screw provided at the top, which is along with the ball and socket arrangement provided with the tripod stand. Once it is fixed in clockwise direction, remember I am rotating it in clockwise direction so as to have the locking. And so as to have the locking, as it has been moved in clockwise direction, now you should not turn the compass in anti-clockwise direction. Otherwise, the locking will unlock. Now the first step, centering. Second is fixing. Now third is we have to check the leveling with possibly the circular pen. See, it is leveled. Once you check with this way and then with 90 degrees position. This is one way of checking the leveling. Or otherwise, you can see whether the aluminium graduated ring is rotating freely or not. Then take out the cap of the prism. Keep the prism ready for taking the reading and always rotate the compass in clockwise direction. Why I have told you? Because if you rotate in an anti-clockwise direction, there are chances that that compass may get unlocked. Now from this, I will take the reading towards AB line. So we have said this as the A station, That station is B, and the third station is C, which is with a black and white ranging rod. So first of all, I will take the reading, and while taking the reading, what you have to do is, you have to stand on other side, turn the compass in such a way that the object, when along with the cross or horsehair, will stand exactly on the ranging rod, looking through the vertical slit provided at the prism. So you can see by your eyes also here, and you have to exactly bisect the rod. Stop. If you see exactly here, see, with a vertical slit I am rotating and able to see how the ranging rod is able to bisect, and then you have to take the reading. Suppose, as told to you, there are three lines, we said. So from A station, AB line, then we'll move to B, so BC line, and then we'll move to C, CA. So that is completing the triangle. Now I am on station A. So from station A, I will take two bearings. One is the four bearing of AB line, and from station A in a reverse direction on a back side, but I will able to see the C station. So back bearing of CA line, don't say AC line. Because here, always from A, B or C, I am going to take four bearings. And from B, C, A, I am going to take the back bearing. So the readings are to be entered properly. So now from station A, whichever the four bearing I will take, it will be entered in AB's line, four bearing column. And back bearing taken from A station, but that will be CA line, back bearing column. Okay? Bisection is over. And if I say, the readings are always increasing from right side to left side. So I am able to see after the bisection and the reading matching, 260 I am able to see. So 260, 1 degree, 262 degree. So the exact reading is 262 degrees, 30 minutes. That is the four bearing of AB. In the similar way, now I will rotate the compass in clockwise direction till I will be able to bisect the ranging rod at station C. So this is CA line, the back bearing is 310, 11, 12. So it is 312 degrees, 30 minutes. So that's way you have to take the reading. Now see, we are at station A. From A, we have taken a reading to B. So it is AB and then CA line. Now I should move clockwise or anticlockwise, it is pre-decided. So I have decided to go from in a clockwise direction. So from A, I will go to B. And from B, I will take four bearing for BC and back bearing of AB. Then I will move to station C. I will measure four bearing of CA and back bearing of BC line. And see, I am completing the procedure. Now, while holding the station and the all instruments, first of all, this object vane is to be laid on the lid, and hold the instrument is to be taken up. Okay.
Ma'am. बरोबर इथे
तर फक्त मध्ये एकदा ऑन करा मॅडम व्हर्टिकल ठेवा तो सगळं खाली ठेवा असं घुसवा मध्ये व्हर्टिकल नाही होतो नाही मॅडम
ओके
वेल नाउ द सेम प्रोसिजर इज टू बी रिपीटेड आय विल टेक आउट द रेंजिंग रॉड आय विल इन्सर्ट द पेग आय विल मेंटेन द व्हर्टिकलिटी ऑफ द पेग अँड अगेन आय विल स्टार्ट विथ positioning, or rather the centering of the tripod stand. The legs are to be taken radially outward, and I will try to match up the center. I will fix the legs and I will check the centering with small stone pieces. See, it is exactly fall at the center. Still I will try one more time to check whether my work is exact or not. It has exactly fall. So the next step is, again from this station B, I will rotate the compass in clockwise direction and I will bisect the ranging rod at C. So remember, this is BC line. Of course, here you have to check the leveling. The aluminium ring should be freely suspended. So after the bisection, I will take the reading on the compass, which is exactly coinciding with the horsehair, by going little bit down. Okay, now to bring the aluminium ring at the center, I will use the brake pin so that
the aluminum ring will come to the rest at the earliest. So there are some vibrations. So I am taking the reading of BC line. The four bearing is 13 degrees, 13. And the back bearing of AB line taken from B towards A, and the reading coming out to be 81 degrees 30 minutes. Okay. Now while changing the position from station B to C, what you have to check is the instrument should be vertical. There are some other reasons which have been explained in the class. So the compass should be taken in a vertical position. Take out the ranging rod, keep it aside, put the peg, and again start doing the same procedure of fixing the compass is over. Now centering, that is positioning the instrument exactly on the station point, is to be carried out by moving the legs gradually inward and outward, and again check the centering. So I will check the centering. So it has been fault here, that means this leg is to be turned radially inward. This means this is to be taken radially outward, and two or three settings, it requires little bit practice. So it is exactly falling rather, but still I will take this leg little bit outside, which may ensure the exact centering of the instrument. So centering is over. Now again from the station C, I will take the four bearing of CA line. Now see, because of the sunny day, the light is coming on the screen. So after the bisection, I will take the four bearing of CA line. Exact bisection is over and the reading is 132 degrees, and I will take the back bearing of B to C line taken from C station after the bisection, and the reading coming out to be 193 degrees. So this way I have completed the whole loop and all the six readings. Stop. So this is the table which you have completed. Again I will narrate. See, from station A we have taken four bearing of AB and back bearing of CA line. Then we move to station B. From B we have taken four bearing of BC and from station B back bearing of AB. Similarly from station C, four bearing of CA and back bearing of BC line. So this is the table which is to be worked out for the included angle, and then if any corrections to the angles is to be corrected either with the two methods which have been explained in the class. Yeah. So as the readings are taken, let us mark the triangle. Say this is station A with this as the north. So A to B, 262 degrees 30 minutes. So this is 90, 180 and 270. So it is very close to 270. So let us draw a line for which the distances are to be measured. Let us say, I will assume here somewhere is the B station, wherein this bearing is 262 degrees 30 minutes. Now four bearing of BC is 13 degrees. So from here I will draw a line, okay, and this is at a degree of 13 degrees B to C. But whether I should consider here or above or here, because either that will go in the third, maybe third, fourth or first quadrant, for which a check is from station A we have already taken the back bearing, okay, from A we have taken back bearing of CA line, which is 312. So 312 will be somewhere here in the fourth quadrant. So I will draw that line wherever these two lines are meeting will give you the exact position. So if I say station A, station B and station C, so now you can check this is 4 bearing of BC and 4 bearing of CA is 132, which I am marking here now 132 degrees. Similarly, from station A, I will mark the back bearing. Now from A to C, I have seen, no? So that bearing is C here, whole circle bearing. Bearing measured with respect to north in clockwise direction. And that is 312 degrees, 30 minutes. Similarly, from station B, the back bearing of AB line. So if you measured with respect to north in clockwise direction, and that value is 81 degrees 30 minutes. 81 degrees 30 minutes. See the angle, it is less than 90. And at station C, if you see the back bearing of BC line taken from C with respect to north, taken in a clockwise direction, and that angle is little bit more than 180, and that is coming out to be 193 degree. So this is what the area I had covered. Now with a tape of 30 meters, you have to measure the distances AB, distances BC and distances CA just to check the accuracy of this marking, whether the distances are also coming same or not. And this may be the area which you want to survey. So this whole area which we have covered with these three stations. If the area is larger, you can go for n number of 4, 5 or 6 number of stations.
Okay.
So as written here, this is 30 meter step, Freeman's Fiber, it is the company. Here it is to wound the tape. When you take it out, remember for a tape, the distance starts with this ring. Okay. So from here the zeroth start, and we are measuring the distance in meters. So here if you see, up to this is the 10 centimeters, 20 centimeters, 30 centimeters. So 20 to 30, every line is of 1 centimeter. The biggest line, middle one, is of fifth one. So 5 centimeter more than 20. So it is 25, 26, 27, 28, 29 and 30. And this way it is marked 1 meter, 2 meter, likewise with a red color at 30 meters. Give the jerks so that the tape is checked whether it is laying horizontally or not. And if you take the reading is somewhere here. It is coming out to be 15 meters. So 15.5 meter is the distance. Same the way.
Stop.
Now again, the 00 is kept at B. Give the jerk so that all the bushes and trees are coming in between. The tape will be laid straight. And if you measure the distance, see 13 meters is over, 13.4 and 5, so 13.45 meters. The 00 at C and give the jerks and measure the distance. Now it is 16.37, or you can say 16.38 meters is the distance of CA line.
Okay, please enter all the details and you can solve the numerical. Already we had solved the numericals by using the same type of data in the classroom. Thank you.